Hey guys, I want to show you this Bauer 5-piece filter kit for GoPro cameras. It's marketed for the 3 plus cameras, but it will definitely work on the 4s. They use the same housing and the camera's the same shape. So I'm not a fan of big long unboxing, so I'm just going to show you what's in here and then we'll see some sample footage. The kit comes with a circular polarizer, which is really why I wanted it for the polarization. This is a UV filter. This is the adapter that goes on the naked camera, and this is for that waterproof housing. The 3 Plus and the 4 have the same waterproof housing, and if you upgrade your housing, you can actually put a 3 in one of the newer housings and it'll work that way too. Here is a naked camera. This is the 4, and it just slips right on, and then your filters just screw on. It's real easy. Here is the 4 case, the waterproof case, and the filter adapter just drops right on. The only part that I don't like about this setup is that it takes an Allen wrench on the side here. That it comes with a kit, but you've got to tighten it on. I was, kind of wanted one that was just an interference fit so you could just, snap it on. But anyway, once it's on there, it's real secure. This tether comes with, it's got little places here to tether it if you're doing some vigorous activity. So here's a case for the filters. They just slide in here. There's a place for 3 filters. The cool thing about this kit is that it has the 2 adapters, and these take 52 millimeter filters, and that size filter is very common. You can get hundreds of different filters in 52 millimeter. So if you buy this kit and get the 2 adapters, you can add whatever filter you want. These adapters are made out of aluminum. It doesn't really say in the advertisement if they are aluminum, so they're pretty strong. This kit is relatively inexpensive compared to some other ones. You can get some Polar Pro filters for about $30, but they only fit one or the other. They don't fit the housing and the naked camera, and that's just one type of filter. Polar Pro makes a 3 filter set for $50, but again, it just fits either the naked camera or the housing. Some of the Snake River filter setups and adapters are like $100 or more, so this is a pretty good deal.
So these circular polarizing filters are adjustable. You mount them on the camera, and then the outer ring rotates 360 degrees. At certain points in that rotation, the image will look normal with no change. About 90 degrees from that place in the rotation should be about maximum image change. What I'm doing here is I'm using the GoPro app to view the image before I start recording. Another way to do this is to take the filter off and look through it with your naked eye and just decide what you want it to look like, make a note of where the rotation is, and then put it back on the camera. Here you can see the regular image with no change, and as I rotate the filter, the sky and the lake get darker and the greens get greener. Just kind of makes it pop. Right here we go back to the unadjusted filter and it kind of gets duller, and then we'll rotate it again about 90 degrees, and the blues get bluer and the greens get greener. Just a nice looking picture. Here again you can see another scene where this is standard and then rotated to the full effect of the filter. That may be even a little bit much for some people, so you wouldn't have to go that far if you don't want to. Real blue water and sky. Here we go back to normal. The circular polarizing filters work best when you're filming 90 degrees from the sun. So here you can see I'm turning towards the sun and the effect of the filter becomes less. We'll turn back and you can see the water starts to get bluer and the sky gets bluer, and that's without adjusting a filter. That's just the angle of shooting. Here we're shooting just about straight into the sun, and you can see how much the filter takes the glare off the water. As I rotate here, the glare on the water goes away. Since we're pointing into the sun, the color of the water and the sky don't really change, but the glare does go away on the water. Here's another great example of how the filter takes the glare and reflections off the water. It helps you see into the water in certain circumstances. Here's a good example of a shot that's real bright and a lot of reflections, looks real white. Then when you dial in the filter, those reflections go away and the greens get greener and just really makes for a much better video. Here again, we're shooting about 90 degrees from the sun. This is without filter. It's kind of dull. And then we rotate, the water gets blue and the sky gets blue and the colors just kind of get more vibrant. Here's another good example of where you can see into the water better when the filter's adjusted. Again, the colors are better in the sky and the trees. I think you can overdo this a little bit, but it's a lot of fun to play with. I appreciate you guys watching. If you like my videos, please subscribe and let me know if you have any questions.